much longer are they going to make me wait? How much longer are they going to make me wait? How much longer are they going to make me wait? How much longer are they going to make me wait?
May I help you, madam?
I've explained why this to the... lady. Why... I'm... here.
Yes. The lady told me, and also that you're a member of the International Society for the Suppression of White Female Slave Traffic.
Yes. I am indeed a member of the International Society for the Suppression of White Female Slave Traffic. And even if I were not, I would have made this journey. I pursued that unfortunate girl for a full 9 months, but every time I got close, she'd been carted off to another city. This time I know she's here. In this house. At this very moment. The lady informed me no uncertain terms. She's bringing her here for a private and undisturbed conversation. I have her word. I expect her momentarily. I also don't wish to be subjected to further questioning.
Please don't excite yourself, madam. The girls simply want to appear properly dressed.
You needn't trouble yourself with polite conversation. The atmosphere in this room is nothing new to me. The first time I entered a house like this, I had to resist considerable physical discomfort. I realized then the enormous self-control required of me as a member of the Society for the Suppression of White Female Slave Traffic till that time. Our efforts were nothing more to me than an idle pastime. I didn't wish to grow old without having accomplished something of value.
Your words awaken great sympathy, madam. Would you honor me with your credentials as a member of the International Society for the Suppression of White Female Slave Traffic? Experience tells me that many force their way into the profession not only to rescue fallen women. If you're serious in achieving this goal, then you must welcome the control we are forced to exercise as well.
I've been a member of the society for almost 3 years now. My name is Miss Von Malthus.
How free.
How is it you know my name?
We do read society's papers. You know, if I'm not mistaken, you've distinguished yourself as a speaker at last year's annual conference.
I'm ashamed to say that for 2 years all I did was write and speak. And speak and write. But the courage to come to grip with the traffic itself. Until that same traffic has led a victim from under my own roof. From within my own family.
Okay, dear Miss Von Malthus, perhaps it was your own papers, books, and journals there to lay. Which of course you failed to keep away from that hand. Of the young creature you came here to rescue.
Quite right. Yes, I can't possibly contradict you there. Night after night, content with myself and the world, I lay beneath the covers for 10 hours of undisturbed sleep, never dreaming what was happening. For at the same time, that 17-year-old creature would steal into my study. And allow her love-starved imagination to conjure up out of those piles of books on the campaign the most seductive images of sensual pleasure and license. And, stupid fool that I was, despite my 28 years, the next morning I failed to notice that the girl had been up all night. I've never in my life experienced a sleepless night.
If I'm not mistaken, it was your parents who hired the girl for some light household duties.
Total relation, yes. Both Mama and Papa were absolutely enchanted with her modest and proper manners. Papa, a civil servant and bureaucrat of some standing, considered her presence in the house a veritable ray of light. Following her sudden disappearance, neither Mama nor Papa ever spoke of my activity in society as spinsterish hysteria, but as an unmitigated crime.
The girl is an illegitimate child, a washer, and a friend. Do you perchance know who her father is?
I didn't ask. Who are you? How do you know?
The girl read in one of your society's papers that certain misrepresenting advertisements were being published in daily papers by means of which white slave dealers would lure young girls into the market. She sought out one of these advertisements and wrote a very proper letter proposing herself for the position. That is how I became acquainted.
Damn, you're so cynical with
me on this. My dear Miss Von Lathers, I should call it practical.
You're the monster responsible for this girl's disgrace.
My dear young lady, if you realize the cause of your excitement, you might be intelligent enough to remain silent in front of a monster you take.
I don't understand. I don't know what you're trying to say.
Are you still
the love market is the curse of the female sex.
All we ask for the love market to operate as openly and freely as any other honorable trade. If you want to oppose the oppression of your sex, then place the blame where it belongs, directly on the shoulders of the bourgeois society. On the other hand, if you want to defend the natural right of your sisters, then oppose your very own international society for the suppression of white female
to
traffic!
I'm convinced that you're not in the least interested in releasing the girl. Well, I've sat here like a fool listening to your sociological lecturing. That poor creature's probably been packed off to where she'll be forever safe from the society for the suppression of white female flag traffic!
Unfortunately, my dear young lady, if you realize how your emotional outburst has improved your somewhat homely appearance, she might be in such a rush to leave.
Let me out of here. It's high time!
Where do you think you're going? You will stay here. I have something to tell you. Oh, go ahead, scream. God, here you have all sorts of human utterances in this place. Scream as loudly as you like. But I still need to start some sense of you before you go front into the authorities.
I have never experienced such a show of violence.
Years of your life I just spent making excuses for these women of pleasure, as you call them. Why not perform a useful act? Promote happiness. Now we needn't be so worried about these young. The love market is so terrible because women have chosen to sell themselves to men for nothing as opposed to being paid for their sex. And in so doing, they have degraded their own sex the way a... tailor degrades his... Becoming a mother is as much a necessity of nature as breathing or sleeping. But bourgeois society has barbarically denied this inborn right. There is one thing about this feminist movement that sickens me. It is the moral attitude you have installed with your disciples to rule their lives. Let me ask you, do you honestly that the love market would be considered so shameful a profession if men were allowed to compete in it along with women? Professional jealousy, my dear. Professional.
I'm in no condition just now to determine whether your observations are right or wrong. But how can a man with your education, with your view of society, with your intellectual superiority, spend his life in the most worthless elements of human society? God knows it may have been your animal brutality that forced me to take you seriously. You've given me things to think about for a long time to come, things I never would have hit upon myself. Every winter now, for many years, I listen to a plethora of lectures from every conceivable male or female authority on the subject of feminism. And not one of them is not at the heart of matters you have just done.
We must not forget, my dear lady, that sleeping is like sleepwalking. I'm a moralist.
And you complain of it? You complain that your destiny is to help others? Never occurred to me till now to give myself to a man. You're right. I've had no experience. I never knew the meaning of the word love. Till now. Here with you for the first time, love raises us above our wretched selves. I'm an ordinary woman, but my love for you has suddenly made everything possible. Please, don't waste another moment to marry me. It'll be the salvation of both of us poor wretched creatures.
Whether you love me or not means nothing to me.
And know for once in your life the superhuman sacrifice a woman will is capable of.
The most your superhuman sacrifice could do for me would be to turn my stomach. I have loved tigresses all my life, but I have never been more than a stick of wood. My only consolation is that marriage, which you are so very fond of, and for which bitches are bred, is a cultural institution. And cultural institutions are meant to be overthrown. Humankind will overthrow marriage as sure as it has overthrown slavery. The love market, a market which attacks, celebrates his tribe, is based upon the natural law of unchanging creation. How proud a woman will then be when she can sell herself to the highest bidder without being branded for it. What a glorious sound. The phrase, a woman of pleasure. Whom she wants. She seduces when she wants. She does not wait for love.
Marry me. You're not a man of this world. Today, for the first time, I offer my hand to a
red and better culture. If you could control love the way you control politics, then this world would be free of morality.
All I ask of my marriage is to lie at your feet and listen to you.
Have you ever considered what marriage is?
I never had reason to. Till now. Tell me, I'll do anything to meet your requirements.
Please, sit down. So, you wanted to know what love is. Tell me, who is stronger? A man with a dog or a man without a dog?
A man with a dog is stronger.
Uh-huh. Now tell me, who is stronger, a man with one dog or a man with two dogs?
I think the man with one dog is stronger because two dogs would become jealous of each other.
Mm-hmm.
Is this meant to explain the selfless, indissoluble union between man and wife?
A man with a wife is economically stronger than a man with none. That is the basis of marriage. No one in her wildest dreams could have hit upon so ingenious an invention.
You poor, pitiable creature. How did you ever know the love of a father's house? Didn't you have a mother who looked after you when you were ill? Read you fairy tales while you were recuperating, whom you could turn to with your troubles, and who always, always held you near a certain end. That's all bliss.
Imagine yourself in a body of a boy of 16 who's still beaten for not understanding logarithms. It was my father. Back. My father died. He died after the first beating. But is it true? You see, the sort of women I live among here, not one of them has been insulted the way my mother has been insulted daily throughout my childhood. But these are trifles. Trifles compared to the slaps, bips and bolts that my mother and father and a dozen tutors competed with each other to inflict on my defenseless body, but these are trifles. Trifles. Compared to the slaps, kicks, and blows that the vicissitudes of life have attempted to degrade my defenses. So.
No idea how deeply I love you for this dreadful experience.
Living is a dance, rolled into one. No. But for you, and for everyone who lives and breathes, life, for a simple man, is nothing but pain, agony, and torment.
And there'll be no more torment. You'll no longer be concerned with these problems. My mama has a fortune of 60,000 marks, which my father, even after 25 years of having marriage, still knows nothing about. Doesn't the prospect of 60,000 marks for marrying me tempt you?
My dear miss, it's obvious that you're ignorant in the art of love me. You are a donkey trying to be loved. It's a crazy. You have no sense of delicacy. No sense of delicacy, no sense of shame. You lack the necessary feel for the warmth of your caresses. A feel that most men of breeding are born with.
How dare you speak to me like that in this house?
Yes, I dare speak to you like that in this house.
In this house, no sense of delicacy, no sense of shame.
No sense of delicacy, no sense of shame. Yes, I dare say that to you in this reputable house. The least girl knows more about the human heart than the most famous professor of physiology at the most famous university. I know at first glance a woman made for the love market. She's a woman of happy innocence and innocent happiness, radiating in her open features. In your features, dear, I see neither happiness.
But you don't believe that my industry, my energy, my enthusiasm for all that's beautiful can teach me that sense of delicacy intact.
No, 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 my dear lady, no!
I'm so convinced of the moral validity of all that you've said, that no sacrifice could be too great to overcome my middle class inadequacy.
No, 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 don't destroy that single happiness in the dark night. That must not be trampled upon by clumsy feet.
I don't understand what you mean. What is a single hope I'm not to destroy?
Unadulterated happiness that life can produce. The only reason and thing that has kept me alive for these past 50 years has been the selfless worship of this single happiness. Its full throated laughter makes up to us through our senses for all the torment.
I think someone's coming.
Probably this
is Francisca. Who's Francisca?
The young girl who read all those book of yours on sensual pleasure and vice. But now is the time for me to prove to you that I have not been boasting. From here, my dear lady, you will observe the pure, unalloyed happiness brought together by two people by means of sensual. I haven't come here to waste time, and I am no depraved fool lured by your charms. I'll leave once my sanity has been restored.
My, hard to be friendly. There's no need, you know. You're the master. You, man. One slap of your manly hand will bring the blood rushing to my bloodless cheek. What more can a whore want? Oh, I know I whimper, I sob and complain, but don't let it bother you. I'm used to it. I'm a bitch! Treat me like what? Smash my face. Use your fists. Do it. But not even that will satisfy my.
You call this a welcome?
Is this some kind of atonement before you get to purgatory?
No, that's true. It's here. Inside. Raging. Demonic. Hurt.
I came here to buy love, taste of love, but you have given me thorns to chew.
Don't be heartless. Don't turn away. These desires are not desires of prisoners trapped in this house, but from ourselves, from the tormenting greed of our senses, the terrible greed that drives us here. Hoping each time that my torment would end with the next.
But each time, there was only bitterness. Each time, I found no peace. But only that infernal urge that left room for joy.
And finally, you found your way here to live a life of filth and lewdness. Blaring music, champagne, soap, tables, greeting each dawn with roars of laughter. Hot tongues whispering of love. What a miserable beggar I am. I came to buy love. A simple exchange. I'd hate myself now for what I've done. Your life is a foul pursuit of pleasure. I came for refreshment, not to lose myself in the filthy depths of depravity.
No! If you leave now, when I come to please stay! Your heavenly word go with my desire, and make me please! Let me be! Let me be! I'm held in my arms! No!
Go back to where you came from, and scribble my name in your little book with a smirk on your face.
Now I can't even trust my senses. All the nights I've wept, repulsed by women, and now for the first time, a whore stammers out that she loves me.
Never trust a whore. My duty is to pretend that love. Imagine what it's like when suddenly a door is ripped open and love is scraped together on the spot because a man stands there as God created him. Shall we play a game, or in the end I feel disgust when your passion spurts? No! Be mortified, my flesh! Take your pleasure! That, if anything, can bind us together!
Not even this house has corrupted you. Your purity blinds me. You grovel in the constant fear of suicide, struggle with an unending anguish. Death in your quiet heart, hate in your heart for the vanity of human happiness. Let me be a friend. You've raised me up. Now I see. I will teach the world to know the unspeakable anguish of love that has bought its soul. Tell me, has love ever brought you happiness?
Love is only one thing, eternal torment and unfulfilled longing. Oh, how I wish you would beat me till I'm done!
Dead.
Blood be flat.
Angel, hush. What is it but a foul, repulsive misery of human existence? What is it but diabolical? Is that what's left?
What's left for you?
I'll tell you. You're a dealer in women. You're proud of it. You're the best connection of anyone in the business. Sell me. Please, think of the price you could ask.
Who will save me for this? I scotch.
I will.
Who are you?
Send sensual pleasure in death. I want to be slaughtered on the altar of sensual love. I want to die a martyr's death!
Shh.
In life, you have warned me from the very death of your soul. Forgive me for approaching you this last time. Not even in your most terrible dreams could you have imagined a final disappointment. That in death, your eyes would be closed by a virgin.
We'll be running this show tomorrow and after tomorrow. So welcome. Come again if you like it so much. And bring your friends and friends. Just don't worry. Thank you.